Reactions of your body to visiting every planet. Hello everyone, welcome to our channel. If you're curious about what pizza moon smells like, please keep watching. Mercury. Mercury is the smallest planet in the solar system. It's a cratered, rocky planet that closely resembles the Earth's moon. The whole surface of the planet is covered with craters. This happens because the planet doesn't have any real atmosphere to protect its surface, so it's quite likely that some kind of meteorite would crash on the surface and kill you. Due to its close position to the sun, the planet is subject to angry radioactive solar winds. This might be another reason: death from effects of radiation exposure. Of all the planets in the solar system, Mercury has one of the largest changes in temperature. During the day, it reaches crazy 800 degrees Fahrenheit, while at night the temperature plummets to minus 340 degrees Fahrenheit. While the planet's rotation is relatively slow, you might spend some time on the border of two regions with the temperature of about 200 degrees Fahrenheit there. Venus. Venus, our extremely hot neighbor, possesses a gaseous atmosphere composed of deadly carbon dioxide with haze and rains of sulfuric acid. Venus achieves a temperature of 870 degrees Fahrenheit. Whew, that's hot. Venus has a very hot and thick atmosphere. You wouldn't survive a visit to the surface of the planet. You would burn up in temperatures high enough to melt lead. The entire surface of the planet is permanently shrouded in clouds composed of poisonous gases. Plus, the winds are extremely powerful. Besides, it might rain sulfuric acid sometimes. Winds of about 224 miles per hour keep the clouds of Venus in constant motion, like a voracious hot hurricane. It's very difficult to live on a planet that has little or no sunlight at all, since the clouds reflect 90% of the sunlight. Earth. We like it here on Earth. It's the only place in the solar system where we can survive even in its coldest locations like North or South Poles. The habitable zone of the solar system makes Earth a real gem for the development of life. It's neither too hot nor too cold to support liquid water, thought to be a key ingredient for the birth of various life forms. Earth is definitely the place. We feel pretty comfortable here, but we're also eager to explore the solar system and beyond. Mars. The mysterious red ball possesses stark landscapes with both high mountains and the deep, long valleys. At this time, Mars' surface cannot support life as we know it. If the landscape doesn't bother you, think about a very low atmospheric pressure that will make your body fluids vaporize. You'll get multiple burns because you can't hide from the UV radiation anywhere. Mars is also famous for its intense dust storms, which can range from small tornadoes to planet-wide phenomena. The warm, dust-filled air rises, and the winds get stronger, creating storms that can measure up to thousands of kilometers in width and last for months at a time. When it comes to the weather on Mars, the forecast is usually quite dramatic. Not only does Martian weather vary from day to day, it sometimes varies from hour to hour. Because of this thin atmosphere and its greater distance from the sun, the surface temperature of Mars is much colder than what we experience here on Earth. The planet's average temperature is minus 51 degrees Fahrenheit, with a low of minus 225 degrees Fahrenheit during the winter at the poles, and a high of 95 degrees Fahrenheit during summer. Jupiter. Jupiter will only welcome you for 1 second before crushing you with raging winds and hurricanes. It's a mostly gas world, mostly hydrogen and helium. The Great Red Spot is the biggest storm in the solar system that's raging with sustained wind speeds from 270 to 425 miles per hour. It's the most ferocious cyclone ever recorded in space. Scientists discovered the howling monster storm penetrates 200 miles below the surface of its atmosphere. Gravitational and acoustic waves produced by the storm heated up to 2,420 degrees Fahrenheit. Since 1979, its size has shrunk by thousands of miles, but it won't save you anyway. Plus, we're still not sure if you can land on its surface, since there is none. It's a gas giant. Jupiter's moon Io, or Pizza Moon. Also known as Jupiter's Pizza Moon, Io is known for fiery volcanoes spewing on its surface. Just look at it. It looks like my favorite pizza, with fat-free crust and extra cheese. Jupiter's moon Io is the most volcanically active world in the solar system, with hundreds of volcanoes, some erupting lava fountains dozens of miles high. Io even has lakes of molten silicate lava on its surface. No need to go there to know that it smells like rotten eggs on Io. Saturn. It's another gas giant, so you'll be sinking in its clouds forever, until powerful winds crush you. It spins faster than any other planet, creating crazy whirlpools on its surface. You won't even have time to blink before turning into space dust. Saturn contains three layers of clouds, so you'll never see the sun in here. The atmosphere of the planet is characterized by super-fast winds, which can reach up to 1,100 miles per hour, combined with heat rising from the planet's interior. The deeper you dive into the planet's gaseous atmosphere, the more difficult it is to be there. Pressures in this region equal those found a few miles under Earth's ocean. Fried and ripped to pieces. That's what will happen to you. Uranus. There's no chance to survive here, too. Uranus has no solid surface to land on, and even if we manage to place you close to it, the pressure will crush you in no time. However, the gravity in the upper layers of the planet is almost the same as on Earth. Uranus is 15 times the mass of Earth, respectively, and its oceans are crushed by pressures millions of times more intense than the air pressure at Earth's sea level. Lightning storms turn methane into carbon, which as it falls hardens into chunks of graphite. Neptune and its moon Triton. Yeah, Neptune is known for strong winds, sometimes faster than the speed of sound, the fastest detected yet in the solar system. One of 13 moons of Neptune, Triton is considered to be the coldest place in the whole solar system. Its surface temperatures of around minus 391 degrees Fahrenheit. Just try to imagine the following fact. The lowest temperature when atoms stop moving is 1 Kelvin, or minus 460 degrees Fahrenheit. The planet has a lot of ice volcanoes or cryovolcanoes that spit ice and ammonia into space. As you battle the blizzard during a snowy day, just be happy you don't live on Triton. Pluto. Did you watch our video about Pluto and Charon? They're a wonderful pair. Pluto and Charon are acting like a dumbbell in space, rotating around each other in a near-perfect lockstep. However, it's not that romantic on the surface of the planet. Pluto's very thin atmosphere extends 100 miles from its surface, about 5 times higher than earlier models had predicted. Pluto's distance from the Sun is 3.67 billion miles, so you can imagine how chilly it is out there. The surface usually warms up to minus 428 degrees Fahrenheit. Plus, it's mostly ice and rock that cools the air even more. Pluto's rotational axis is highly tilted at 122.5 degrees. This would give one side of the planet extremely long periods of darkness or light, depending on that side's orientation to the sun. So, eternal day or eternal night, not everyone can bear that. What do you think would be the worst experience in space? Share your ideas with us in the comments. Don't forget to share this video with your friends, because they have to know what it's like out there.